The NBA playoffs, they kick off this weekend, and your Denver Nuggets are in action against the Portland Trailblazers starting on Saturday night. So to break it all down, Katie Wingy, reporter for Altitude TV and the Denver Nuggets. Katie, thanks so much for joining us. It's the playoffs. How are we feeling?
Well, it's actually funny because this whole season has been so condensed. I feel like they've jammed so much into such a short amount of time. And with the Nuggets having such a short off season, this week has felt like the longest week ever. Obviously, the Nuggets have needed the rest and love the preparation time, but I think everybody is just so eager and excited to get going with these play-in games that have been happening. Basketball's obviously still taking place, but the Nuggets are like excited to get back on the court and get back to playing basketball, and I'm just excited to take it all in.
I'm sure the fans are too. Okay, so they come in the 3 seed in the West, taking on Portland. But yet it still seems somehow this team is being overlooked. Is that kind of the sense that you're getting?
Yeah, and this team always has been. And it's something that Coach Malone and a lot of the players will talk about, how they haven't gotten the respect that they feel they deserve over the past couple years. I think a lot of that does have to deal with the fact that they lost Jamal Murray. Of course, people are going to doubt, but I think this Nuggets team actually thrives in situations where people are looking at them as underdogs or counting them out of certain situations. So it's something that these guys really like, and they've risen to the occasion. You've seen them do that, being down 3-1 twice last season. We'll see what they can do this playoff run.
Well, during this playoff run, I want you to give me one thing to watch and then one player not named Nikola Jokic to watch as we get things started.
So defensively, I think you need to watch for the way that the Nuggets defend the three-point line, because that is going to be a key. It's my number one key. Obviously, you're not going to stop them from doing what they usually do, but how can you make it more difficult? How can you make them feel uncomfortable? And I think that that's what they're going to focus on. They average 42 three-point attempts a game. They're going to chuck it from all over the floor, and they're going to get them in a variety of ways. So how does Denver defensively change up different looks and make sure that they know shooters and make them do something than just shoot wide open threes? Another player for you to watch, in my opinion, is Michael Porter Jr. And he's a guy that has been talked about a lot coming into this playoff series. So now the question mark is, okay, it's more of a real NBA playoff type feel with fans and going into hostile environments and opponents' arenas. So how does his game transfer in that regard? And he said he loves that stage. He welcomes that type of pressure. So for me, if the Nuggets want to be successful, you need Michael Porter Jr. to have an outstanding series, and you need him to keep producing at the efficient level that he has been.
All right. Well, the Nuggets tip off Saturday night against the Portland Trailblazers. Katie Wingy, thank you so much for the time. Go Nuggets. I hope to do this again next round.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me on. Go Nuggets.